Hey guys, Ryan coming at you with another video. It's the second video today that I've done. And if you didn't check out my last video, it's kind of a general update, me talking about, you know, what's going on and what my plans are and stuff like that. So before you watch this one, actually you could watch this one, but after you're done with this one, just check out that video. And I just uploaded it right before this one. So in this video, I'm going to just be talking about a couple, you know, Christmas traditions that I've always had. You know, since I was a kid and stuff like that. And maybe some memory. I'm actually going to start out, you know, talking about some memories and Christmas memories I have that are kind of humorous when I look back at them. You know, nowadays you see kids that are, you know, 3 or 4 years old that's when they stop believing in Santa Claus and that kind of a thing. And, you know, it's kind of sad. Like, you know, sometimes I wish I still did because it just brings such a innocent happiness to this holiday and to Christmas in general, like, and enjoying it and stuff. And so I remember specifically when I was a kid, my parents used to make me my older brother. I have a really older brother and then an older sister, and there's like 18 years apart between me and my older brother, who's a couple years older than me, and then there's 18 years down the road is my sister and my other brother. So my oldest brother is like 42, my sister's 40, and I have a, you know, 28-year-old brother, and then I'm 25. Unless I think that's what their ages are. Sometimes I forget. But then again, I always forget that I'm 25. But anyways, when me and my brother Joe, you know, when Christmas time rolled around, we were really happy because we'd write out our Christmas list. My parents would let us mail it off, that kind of a thing. And, you know, I really enjoyed that. Like, I really thought that this was going to Santa. And I was, like, really excited whenever I got everything on the list or some of the things. And one of the funniest memories I had was I didn't really know what to get one year. I believed in Santa until I was, like, 6 or 7. My brother, Joe, I think he knew that Santa wasn't real. And so he knew that my parents were going to get us whatever was on the list anyway. So he would, you know, tell me what to get. One year I was just like, man, I really want to get something fun, but I don't know what to put on my list. You know, I'm not really into video games and stuff. You know, I was into, you know, watching movies. And so, of course, I asked for movies. I think I, like, asked for, like, the Mighty Ducks or something, you know. But my brother was like, hey, man, put a Nintendo 64 on your list and get these games. You'll love it. And so I was like, okay, well, I'll do that. Well, that same year, he asked for a PlayStation. And it was when PlayStation first came out. And so he got it. You know, I wasn't 6 or something. I think I was a little bit older. And I think I may have not believed in Santa anymore by this point, but the story's really hilarious. But because I've never been into video games at all, and so we both got the PlayStation and the Nintendo 64. And I played the Nintendo 64 one time, and then I never hardly played it again, unless it. And so it's just funny because my brother like egged me on to get this thing because he said I was gonna love it, but really he was just telling me this so he'd have a PlayStation and a 64. And even to this day, he's always been obsessed with video games. Kind of like how I am with movies, he's like that with video games. And so, but here's the cool thing. Even though I didn't really like playing it, I mean, I had like Star Fox, Mario 64, I had WWF, Warzone. The best game of all time, in my opinion, that I've ever played was GoldenEye 007 on Nintendo 64. And I just love that game. It's like me and friends would get together and we'd play multiplayer. And, you know, if any of you guys played that game, let me know in the comments what you think of it. And did you have a lot of fun playing it too? Because I just remember that was like the funnest time I ever had playing video games. And so I guess you could kind of say I got cheated out of a Christmas gift because the main gift was really for my brother's entertainment. But eventually I ended up learning to like it. And I still have that 64 to this day. And that's still the only gaming system I ever owned. And so, in fact, I don't even have games on my cell phone. I just get so bored of video games, you know. And so, and I always thought that was kind of funny. And I remember when we used to do Christmas list, you know, Santa list and stuff. And after it was done, my parents were always like, all right, now it's mailed off, so you really have to behave now. And me and my brother, we would get in trouble. We would, you know, we'd go out to dinner, throw food. I mean, do the worst stuff. And I was really loud all the time. I scream and laugh like crazy. And sometimes I'd, you know, I was like the kid from A Christmas Story, you know, like putting potatoes on a spoon and just acting stupid. And so that's how I was. And so we got in trouble. But my dad and my mom would have a close family friend who was from Cuba. I think he was Cuban, but he had a slight Cuban accent. But he would have this guy call the house and say it was Santa. And when we misbehave, and they'd be like, Santa's on the phone, you guys better behave. And I get on the phone, and now I look back, and I was like, wait a second. Why does Santa have a Cuban accent? And so, little stuff like that. I mean, I know I haven't really talked about Christmas traditions or anything like that, but I decided to make a little video just talking about some memories. And, you know, I don't know how many of you guys ever, any of you guys that celebrate Christmas have ever, you know, gotten your tree from a tree farm where you go chop it down yourself. But down here in Florida, you know, there's a lot of, I live in a city, you know, I live in Jacksonville. There's not a lot of tree farms in Jacksonville, so you kind of have to drive across the state. You know, not across the state completely, but, you know, a good 50 miles, 60, I think even 80 miles to get to the nearest tree farm. But when we were kids, me and my cousins and my aunts and uncles would all take a huge drive over to get a Christmas tree out of the farm. And so we'd chop it down, and on our way back, instead of driving all the way back, we would actually stop at this Christmas tree farm. Wait, not stop, we already went there. We would actually stop at a rest area. And we'd all have a huge family picnic. And it was a lot of fun. Me and my brother used to climb this one tree all the time. And, you know, we'd climb it and go really, really high. And there was about 4 years in a row where we, you know, were on this tree. And so, you know, that was our main place to hang out. We'd get our food, go and hang out by the tree. Well, the last year we went there as that family and that, because my parents got divorced and stuff. And so some stuff like that changed. We wouldn't do huge stuff together as a family. But the last year we went there, me and my brother, we were like, yes, yes, it's finally this time of year. It's Christmas. We got our tree. We're cooking out with the family. Oh, yes, let's go to the tree. So we're running to the tree. And then there was, like, bushes and stuff. And once you cleared the bushes, there was the tree. So we're running through the bushes, and all of a sudden, there's a stump. And so it was just, like, it crushed our souls. And it was just, I'll always remember that, just because it was, I look back on it now, and I'm just like, you idiot. Like, it's just a funny story, and you guys might not even find it funny, but I actually have pictures of me, 1 year standing next to the tree in it, me standing next to the tree, my brother in it, and then the next year us sitting on the stump with this, like, the saddest look on our faces. But whatever, that's what happens sometimes, you get your tree knocked down. Well, anyways, you guys, I hope you enjoyed me just rambling on about just different, you know, Christmas traditions that we have and just memories and stuff. But anyways, I'll catch you in the next video. Remember, there's three ways of doing things: the right way, the wrong way, and the chat away. See ya.